Hello explorers and welcome. It's another video. Today I'm going to talk about rendertron. It's a tool that you can use in order to make your website more SEO friendly. As we know, many of the apps that we build today are using a lot of JavaScript. Some of them might be adding more functionality and more visual elements after the render of the HTML document, and some JavaScript runs and fetches the extra content and displays that on screen. And if you are a bot and goes to a website and you don't have the capability of actually rendering and taking the JavaScript into account, then you have the problem of that all the data that you need in order to make this site very searchable is missing for you because you don't have the main content of the site. So to illustrate this, I have this news application. This is a Polymer application built as an example by the Polymer team. And if we have this like this and we load this, you see you get the title and then you get the rest of the elements on this page. And this is something that I have deployed to a service called Now. Really nice JavaScript service that you can deploy three applications to at once if you like, and you can deploy Docker files as well. So if I disable JavaScript and reload this site, we get not so SEO friendly site. We are missing a lot of data in this site, which is very sad. So let's look at some code here. If we go into my example file here, I have this Express application that displays this news page. And I have some other things that I set up here. And then I just say that I want to show some static content. So Bower components are required to show this site. And because everything in this Git repository is just the this index.js, and the news application is something that I added as a submodule from another repository. So in order to run this, I need to say that all the static files are actually in the submodule file directory. So everything that is static, I say that that's inside of the news directory, and they're different values. And if I get any requests to any URL except for these up here, I will actually send that to the index.html. So that's because this is a routed application. So in order for that to work, I need to set it up like this. And then I just have this listen on port 8080. And in order to get this site more SEO friendly, I have this little code up here. So I add the rendertron, I npm install that, and I also add this middleware here. I have tried to actually install the rendertron, and in order to do that, you will need to fetch the latest Chrome. You need to install it with force dependencies, and the dependencies doesn't really land on your system, so you have to run install-f in order to get them. And then you take down the repository that they have, you do an npm install, and you do an npm start. But you have the requirement that you need to use Node.js after 0.706. Six, because they are using async await, and that's not in the current stable version of Node.js, which is on 6 something, and this latest is on 8, version 8, so I don't really get the versioning there. And then we have this application, how you install my application. It's just Chrome clone recursive, so you get the submodule npm install and start. You could also install the Docker image, So there's a Docker image file. And I tried to install that on now as well, but it didn't start now. So maybe you can deploy it to the Gmail cloud or something like that. Everything is in their repository, how to do that. But I was a bit short on time, so I didn't have the time to actually deploy it. So they have actually this rendertronappspot.com where they have deployed this code, so you can try it out. This is not for production, but they said if they have a lot of need from the community to actually have such a URL, they might set up a more permanent service for this. So what is Rendertron then? Rendertron is a render engine that clones and spins up a headless Chrome in order to render your page and serve it back to you. And it serves it back to you if you are a bot. So this little snippet of code we saw up here in our JS, the Rendertron middleware, it actually says that on this render endpoint, it will just add the URL after this and render it. And you can have some more configuration variables to it as well, but it will spin up a Chrome, render it, and give you back the static HTML so you can view it and send it to the actual bot that is going to your page. So if we go back here and I'll render one of my applications here. I think this is the application that will not render correctly because I didn't add anything to it. So yeah, this renders correctly. So it's the other one. No matter what, this is the rendered version going through the Rendertron app spot. So it will render your experience and show you the correct news site. So this site doesn't have the Rendertron added to it. So if I go up here and show it like this and then say that I'm actually a Bing bot that goes to this page, it will not show anything because I haven't added the Rendertron yet. So let's change that back to the default. And I have this new site. It will show correctly. I turn off JavaScript. Then we have the same presentation as we had earlier. And if I now say that I'm a Bing bot, a Bing spider, it will actually render the page correctly. But I still have disabled JavaScript. So this is rendered through the Rendertron, coming back with a result that shows this page. And they have a few limitations that you could configure if you like, but per default, they say that your page must render in 10 seconds. And this solution is not a performance solution that you can actually use to render your page as in production, that you can use to actually render every page of your application. It's not made for that. It's made for bots. Because of the fact that you're actually spinning up a new headless Chrome every time, it's not fast, but a bot doesn't care if it's a fast page to render. If you don't get any data at all, then why? Then it's a really bad experience. But if you can give some data back, even if it's slow, this is a better solution. So, but slow context isn't that slow, actually. It's quite fast. And another thing is that the page will be cached for a reasonable amount of time as well. So if many bots comes and asks for this data, they will get the page quite quickly. So that's pretty much what I wanted to talk about here. Something to note is that if you are using a web component page before the actual new specification of web components 01. So you are using Google's pre-built libraries for that, so Polymer 1 and so on. Then you need to add ?DOM equals shady, because the shadow DOM isn't implemented in those polyfills. So, I hope you found this tool interesting. I think it's very interesting to use if you have a page with that is an app page and you wanted to make it more SEO friendly, especially for other search engines than Google's, because Google's bots actually render your JavaScript, but it could be good that you actually give the same information to all the bots out there. I hope that you learned something today. Please tell me if you are using rendertron and how your experience is, and leave any comment if you want to discuss anything further. I read all the comments. If you haven't subscribed yet, do that, and I really hope to see you in the next video.